拿去。
This is a great afternoon for me because I've done lots of things from the environmental education with accounting and convert the possibility of converting carbon dioxide into renewable energy. EIP, ecological
industry.
Yes. You must forgive me for my ignorance, but this is the first time I've heard about his name. I'm really sorry, but... Right, yeah, so I have some questions. First is, just follow Professor Fu's question. How is that possible? Or if that is possible, that we can apply the EIP idea into some area which we know are heavily polluted, such as the Formosa Industrial Park or the Industrial Park area in the southern Taiwan. I think, is that possible to use a plain language to describe the effect or the possible applicability that we can apply this idea in those heavy industrial areas? And the second, I would like to learn more, if that's possible, from Professor Lin, also on how is that possible to convert the carbon dioxide into a new renewable energy. I think that opened a great door to make this, to convert a gas, which we think is harmful to our climate, but into a marketable or big business potential, and that would be quite helpful. And for the Professor Orisky, I'm surprised to learn that Hurricane Sandy caused such a big damage to the United States. How is that possible? So I would like to learn more about that. And also, you talk about British Columbia. Again, I'm ignorant again. This is the first place in the world, even before Australia, to implement the carbon tax. So I wonder if this kind of implementation had impact on their local economy. Is their economy becoming better or otherwise? So that would be an interesting question to me.
Thank you. Other comments or questions? 也可以用中文问的啊，没问题。
My name is Charles. I'm very interested to listen Dr. Orisky's speech this morning. You talk about who is responsible for climate change. You say governments or those who have delayed action or producers of a fossil fuel and the business community. But my question is, how do you think about NGO or NPO will be have any responsibility? Thank you.
Can I ask our DA or Deputy Administrator? I saw in your slides, that is wonderful, it's a wonderful speech. I think it says producer and the consumer. Producer and the consumer, one of the guidelines. Actually in Taiwan, we have a kind of behavior, not only mentality, also the behavior that consumers, you know, people are gradually get more versed in environmental protection. Not only producer, but also consumer. Yeah, which is actually the core thought could be GMQ, just make quantity. If necessary, some good guys, ethics, or at least they even just make quality, but the quality never be compromised. What do you think about this? And it could be a kind of a 小众市场, minority market. How do you expand it into even to 大众? And not firstly to 分众, then even to 大众. I mean, that's silly question. Thank you.
Yeah, 不好意思，我用中文讲啊，我只是要问其他的两位啊。刚才我问过志愿士，他讲说prognosis 如何去预测啊？那我是说其他的话哈，两位都是比较偏重于工程这部门啊。那我问的是说，关系到那个气象预报那个 forecast 啊。那个在哪个范围内比较准确，就是说还可以接受的，谢谢。
你可以再讲多一点吧，因为你说刚才跟他们聊天我们没有听到，所以可能不太清楚。
刚才我请教志愿士，他是说 Nation Green Accounting 啊，我是说他那个 prognose好不好啦？我主要意思就是说哈，那个反正到最后的结果的话，你看到那个经济的话哈，他都会出一些题目给人家去预测了啊。我是说偏重于统计的话哈，如何去预测那一部门啊？我刚才已经讲过那些 green accounting 就已经过去了，都是经济。这部门的啊，我是说工程这部门不知道能不能，像那个汽油预报在准确的范围内可以接受，谢谢。
There could be a follow-up question for Professor Zhu. Actually, I think major in the green accounting in your model or theory. I mean, I think the major point could be a reduction in your chart, several charts. I mean, in the initial, the first one, alarmed. And actually, if it is shifting to the right, it could be the reduction to the minimum, and to the left, reduction to the maximum. Is that, I mean, actually, that is shifting. I mean, how we keep, yeah, I just want to catch.
To the right is more reduction.
The right is more reduction, to the left
is less reduction.
Okay, so that could be a major issue. Is that right? I mean, actually, you have an initial statement or something like that. Thank you.
Okay, any like final comments?
那我要把剩下的讲完。我想说啊，因为我们看到那个大陆。大陆的那个 environment 非常的恶劣，因为他们是那个，他们是世界的工厂。那我们看到他们有非常多的那个污染。那我想说，那我们在那个新进国家，他们现在工厂都到了这边，但是所以他们需要，他们会产生很多东西出来。那我们以前是看到伦敦，我们在小时候说伦敦是雾都，那我们现在看到北京是雾都。那在这样的一个转换过程，等于这些开发中国家呢，他们是接受了，他们是为了这个先进国家，为了大家的生活，那去产生这些东西，所以他们有很多污染。那如果在这种情形下，我们又来说他们产生了太多的这个 CO2 啊，这个什么东西一大堆东西，然后我们给他这个什么碳税，那是不是等于加重他们的负担？他们本来已经为了要好一点的生活，把他们的环境给污染了，结果现在还要被先进国家用这样的一个碳税的这样的一个大帽子架在他们身上，让他们本来已经很微薄的这个利润更加的减少，这样是不是 OK 的？还有第二个，他们我又想着最后一个问题，那个我们现在听到慈济他们内湖开发，他们提出来了一个绿经济， 的这样的名词。那我想请教一下，他们说这个是国际的趋势，因为他们要把这个保护区那个改变啊，改变地目变成福利社福区。那唯一的就是说，那改变的法律机构呢是经济的原因或者是国防的原因。那他说国防他不可能用嘛，那他说是经济。那什么经济呢？慈济有什么慈济？他们说是绿经济。那我想这个绿经济，他说我不懂这是什么。所以刚刚有提到这个绿的 accountability 啊 ，green accountability 是不是就是所谓那个慈济他们为了要改变的时候说国际上有绿经济的这么一个名词，所以想要请各位的大师帮忙解释一下，哎，这是怎么样？谢谢。不好意思，谢谢。
OK，